criminal world, the pumpkin must be shattered. The painting of Sengai, 1750-1837, highly praised for its imaginative and humorous richness, was that of a pumpkin dancing on top of waves. The inscription that comes with it explains its similarity to the understanding of the ultimate truth that escapes incessantly, despite the most persistent efforts. Sometimes the pumpkin submerges. Over time it emerges once again and floats before our eyes. It just can be grasped. Only trusting blindly and with continuous improvement through the support of faith and the goal of alignment that one is led to the other side in a completely unexpected way, when hope is not even nourished anymore. Often, this only occurs in a more advanced age. This is what Hawkwind, 1685-1768, wishes to convey through his parable paintings, often repeated almost identically, in which two or three blind men groping carefully cross a small bridge. His comment about it says, "May the groping of the blind when crossing a bridge serve as the motto of life during old age." Two things were passed on to the Zen art with a special preference. They are bamboo and orchids, most often attached to bizarre rocks. Thanks to their charming shapes, elegance, and attributes in nature for being an endless source of inspiration, both plants are ideal means of expression and specific of the idea of Zen beauty. Furthermore, this close association between painting and calligraphy offers, especially to the more committed monks, the opportunity of writing immediately and spontaneously spiritual insights or personal sensations. In East Asia, bamboo represents fundamental ethical values. Its growth in straight line is compared to the pure character of one exemplary man. Its steady branch, regular and elastic, to the inner righteousness that, despite all the flexibility of his willingness, reflects the unwavering constance and firmness of a noble man. Its green leaves, always fresh and unchanged, throughout the seasons are compared to the stability, the strength, endurance, and the unwavering loyalty of a self-worth to be a model of ethics. In China, we find passages that show the inexhaustible supply of seeds in blossom. They are full of metaphors. The symbolic bond of this plant with the purity of the founding enlightened spirit has made the peach blossom an integral part of literature and painting cultivated by Zen monks. The peach blossom, along with the bamboo and the pine, were admired since the times of Sun and Yan, as one of the three winter friends. Thus, the image of a white sea of peach trees in blossom was associated with the thought of untouched purity of snow in winter, and in a broader sense, the continual survival during the hardest season. Shakyamuni hardened himself during the 6 years he spent in ice and snow, in the solitude of the mountains, before returning once more to the world in order to proclaim his teaching. In this sense, all of Rikyokuna's images of peach blossoms, at first a mere Minden theme, are appropriate in the religious context of Shusan Shaka. In China, concepts such as ice and gold are metaphors for stillness, linguistic habits adopted by Buddhists in the last stage of Taoism. The orchid represents spring, a happy spirit, symbol of grace reflecting the definitive feminine virtue. It is considered the mother of brush painting. The beauty and grace of the orchid reside in the fragility of its shape, with no violent tendencies. Its fragrance is never exaggerated. The orchid grows wild in the greatest place of inspiration, where the mountain meets the water, or where the Inu meets young. It is on the verge of spring, inviting all to celebrate life. Bamboo stands for summer and is the most painted theme in the East. It represents the strength and the virtues of the male, reflecting a sense of perfect balance with integrity and tremendous flexibility. The perfect gentleman has admirable qualities. The center of the bamboo plant is concave, suggesting humility. Bamboo seems to be always ready to serve, being used in the East almost daily. Bamboo has no flower or fruit, both being considered transitory elements. It is considered the father of brush painting, representing simplicity of life and humble spirit. The peach tree is loved for its cosmic meaning, expressing the revival and flow of life. Its winding reins exhibit an appearance of hardness, especially during its arid existence in the winter, although it keeps hidden mystery and beauty, the promise of spring. This oath is fulfilled when the delicate flowers of the peach appear every January, just in time to greet the new year. The peach, flowering in January frost, is the symbol of hope and tolerance.